Hey guys, welcome to another lunchtime review. Today I'm going to try one of these new Lean Cuisine bowls. This one is the plant-powered one. It's Korean-style rice and vegetables. It is edamame, shiitake mushrooms, kale, carrots, bok choy, and pickled onions over brown and red rice with spicy whatever sauce, whatever that is. It's got two peppers on it. It is a 12-ounce meal or 340 grams. And we bought these at Kroger. They were $2.99. So we're not too awfully expensive. Pretty cheap, actually. 370 calories for the meal. And here's your other info for you. So let's see how we make these things. Nothing there. The bottom. So we're going to leave film on the bowl. Cook for 3 minutes and 30 seconds on high. Stir and recover, and then cook for another minute and a half. So 3:30 stir, and then minute and 30. So let's see. And there it is. Like a bunch of stuff, that's for sure. It's a good size ball, it's heavy. So I'm gonna get this in the microwave and I'll be back. Okay, so here it is out of the microwave. Ooh, steam. Go away, steam. Go away. There we go. It is a very dense, packed meal. And I hate to say it, but it kind of smells bad. It's kind of got a funky smell to it. I'll always keep an open mind when I'm trying stuff, but hopefully it doesn't taste like what it smells like. There you can see the onions. So I'm going to let this cool off because it's super hot. It's been in there, what, 5 or 6 minutes now? Five minutes. So I'm going to let this cool off a minute, and I'll be back.
I gave it just a few minutes to cool off. So here's the bite I'm going to take. It's got a little bit of, I think it's got a little bit of everything in there. So here we go. Definitely has some spice to it.
Ooh.
When they say spicy, they mean spicy. But it's spice like in just heat, hot, spicy. It just like burn your tongue and your whole roof of your mouth. I think they put all that spice in there to cover up some of the funky taste in here, because I do not like the flavors of most of what I just tasted. Let me try to see if I can split off something. I'll put my glass on because it's so tiny. All right, so let's start. Let's start with the carrots. The carrots are a blanched carrot, so they're still got a little bit of a crunch to them. Not bad. The flavors, you really can't taste a lot. What's the edamame? Very, very undercooked for me. Very, still have the very dense texture. The bok choy is kind of all through here. It's kind of like these little green leaves. Usually they're bitter. Yeah, there's some bok choy right there. Has that bitter flavor. That could have been kale too. Bok choy and kale kind of all mixed together for me. The rice itself, I don't know. It's just, there's some of those onions. I don't know what the flavor is that I don't like. It could be the rice itself. It could be that sauce, that gochujang sauce. I don't know. It could be the rice. It could be the edamame. It could be just a mixture of everything. It's just not a flavor that I enjoy. I'm trying to be as open-minded and as fair as possible. This is not a meal for me. I tell you what, you get a lot of food there. I mean, that is a ton of food for 310 calories, is what it was? No, 370. It's a lot. It's a lot of food. It's not one I personally would buy. I'm not into plant-based food necessarily. I don't mind the things that are in here, but that sauce is just hot. It's just hot to be hot. It doesn't really add any flavor to it. I think I'm just getting the individual flavors of the vegetables themselves. And that sauce might have a little bit of that funky flavor too. And then the rice itself kind of has a different flavor as well. not my kind of meal. If you eat like this all the time, if you're a vegetarian or whatever, and you're eating like eating these kind of meals, or plant-based, and you want to eat all plant-based, then you might like this a lot. For me, it's got a bitterness to it, the underlying bitterness that I just don't like, and it's got a funky kind of flavor to it. I can't even identify. I'm going to give it a 2 myself. It's not like the worst thing I've ever had in my life. Like, I can't even eat this and spit it out. Not quite that bad, but it's definitely, for me, below average for far as flavor goes. So it's going to be a 2. Again, you might try this and absolutely love it and eat it all the time. If you do, great. That's more power to you. But for me, it's not something I would enjoy eating any time in the future. So, see, I'm going to give it a 2 out of 5. Hope you enjoy this video, and thanks for watching.